Yugi Bros! What's up, Yugi Bros? Today we got a bit of a different video for you. Instead of a duel video, I was thinking of doing some discussion videos leading up to the new Speed Duel box. I wanted to break this down into segments because the card pool is 193 new cards. So that's obviously too many cards to talk about in one video if I wanted to cover like a good portion of what I think should be in the box. But I do also want to put this into segments for you guys. So for this one, it's going to be the top 10 cards I think should be included in the Speed Duel box for water support. And you guys know how big I am on water support. I've been trying to get Konami to do this one card. I'm gonna feature it. The first card's gonna be in here. It's a certain spell card I think the deck could really, really benefit off of. But without further ado, let us begin, shall we? So kicking it off, I would love to see a Legendary Ocean come to Speed Duels. It's been a long time coming. I think this actually could have came out like a set or two ago, but it's fine. It's fine, Konami. I get it. We're building up here. We're building up. Let's give Mako something to really, really catch the opponent's eye with. And don't make this a skill that would sit on the field. If you want to make it a skill that stays outside of the game, I think that's awesome, but I also think that probably might make this a little too overpowered. Let's just bring this card into Speed Duels, shall we? It's a field spell that says this card's name is always treated as Yumi. So there you go. Replacement Yumi, better Yumi. All water monsters on the field gain 200 attack and defense. This is really good. You know, it's Yumi, but it's not. Yumi pumps up Sea Serpent, Aqua, Fish, and I think Thunder. I could be wrong on one of those. This just gives all water monsters. So we can make something like Kabazol's in Speed Duels, the 1700 dinosaur monster. We can make him 1900 with this, which would be kind of cool. But this is the effect that I really want in this game, and that is reduce the level of all water monsters in both players' hands and on the field by one. So right off the bat, this works for both players, so it's not super, super just OP on your side. If your opponent is playing water, they get to use this ability as well, so it's kind of a double-edged sword there. But the big thing with this is that it transfers all the level 5 freaking monsters in this game to level 4, and all the level 7s to 6. And I know you guys are thinking right off the bat, levy a dragon from a 7 to a 6. This card becomes a powerhouse at level 6. One tribute, 2600 attack, 15 defense, and has the effect of sending a Yumi you control to the grave to destroy all other cards on the field. Man, does Speed Duels need something like this. And by speed, I mean water specifically, because water has been on the backbone of all the decks. It's probably one of the worst decks in Speed Duels since the beginning, and we've had Levia Dragon since the second set, and that was an ultra rare that's never seen play competitively because water just doesn't have enough going for it. It takes too long to set up. It took too long to set up in the beginning when the second set dropped. It takes too long now with everything else being power crept. This deck needs this. So if you stick Levia on the field with one tribute by itself and don't use its effect, this guy comes out at 2800, which is big. I get that. But let's talk about how Moth is in the game. That's a 3500 beat stick that you can drop by sending an opponent's monster to the graveyard. That's one you still have to tribute summon for. Yes, I get that it has this Judgment Dragon effect that destroys all other cards on the field, but come on, Konami. Come on, guys. Give water something to throw it into the spotlight with. It needs more of a push. And it needs, in my opinion, it needs this to be competitive, because telling your opponent that you can drop a 2800 beat stick for one tribute is really, really great and all, but having the effect to blow up the entire board is next level, and this deck needs something like this. And let's be fair here for a second, you still have to hard draw the Daedalus. I mean, you can add it with Legendary Fisherman 2's effect, and you can definitely summon it out with Slushy or something, but it's not like this is just a done deal, you're always going to open this turn one type thing. And this is a deck that does pride itself on going second, but it's been forced to go first because it has to set up. Whereas nowadays, with something like this, if you can get something to special summon on the field, going second, drop a Legendary Ocean, then drop this. Hopefully your opponent doesn't pop your Legendary Ocean. This deck can go off, baby, go off, and it's what I want. I want to see it go off. I want to see it do what it was supposed to do. Another beautiful thing with Legendary Ocean, it turns Legendary Fisherman and Legendary Fisherman 2 into normal summonable monsters. Legendary Fisherman would come out at 2050 as a level 4, and a Legendary Fisherman 2 would come out at 2400 as a level 4, both of which I think would be very, very good. The problem with these two cards is that they do take one tribute to summon, and that's really, really slow. But giving these cards the ability to normal summon for free without tributing definitely speeds up the power of water. You don't have to set up as long, you don't have to waste a turn to put a tribute on the field to hopefully let it survive, so then you can summon these in the following turn. You could just drop these immediately, which is fantastic. I think that would really, really help the Legendary Fisherman skills out. Another card that benefits off of this immensely is Kairoshin. Kairoshin 1800 is a level 5 Sea Serpent, but with a Legendary Ocean, he's 2000 as a level 4 Sea Serpent. That would make this card super, super great. You would be able to bring it out immediately. It's kind of like, at that point, it'd be like a faster Serpent Knight Dragon. It would kind of be on par with the Knight of Legends skill, where you are allowed to normal summon Gaia Knight without tributing. With a Legendary Ocean, you can summon Kairoshin for free without tributing, coming at 2000 attack. And that's just really, really strong. It also turns Crazy Fish, Great White, and High Tide Gyrogen into 1800 and 1850 beat sticks respectively, which is really, really good. I think if Water had that at their disposal in their normal monsters, they'd be much more of a threat to deal with. You can even play Kabazos at 1900, like I've said before. So there's a whole plethora of things that the Legendary Ocean, I think, opens the floodgates, again, no pun intended, for Water. And I would love to see, I just think it's the number one card that can turn the entire deck around. And again, not that I expect it to be a skill, but Konami, in my opinion, and this is just kind of a message towards you guys, if you make these skills, these field spell skills, but keep them outside of the game, I think they become a lot more interesting. Because something like Twisted Personality being outside of the game the entire way, so you can't interact with it, like you can't destroy it, is really, really overpowered in my opinion. But then you make like field spells, like for example, Tomb of the Pharaoh, which all it does is give Gravekeeper monsters 200 and 200, and it's treated as Necrovalley. I understand that does a lot for cards in the future that deal with Necrovalley, but making the spell a trap in the field spell, it just gets popped and that's the game. Same goes for machines. You make Heavy Metal Raiders a skill that interacts outside the game, all of a sudden machines become meta because that entire archetype plays differently than simply just, oh, Dust Tornado, the field spell, and that's the game. If these skills stayed outside the game more often, which I think they should because that's the whole uniqueness to speed duels, outside of the rule changes, the biggest thing is the skills. Having these skills at your disposal, being able to get extra effects off something that normally you wouldn't really be able to have too many interactions with is just so, so fun in my opinion. It's unfortunate to see cards like the field spell skills and the continuous skills, the Call of the Haunted, just be diminished, especially when you start with one less card, because I get it, it's like they're the extra card that you start with, but they can also just be as freely destroyed by a spell or trap card as anything else in the game. I just don't think that's fair to those skills when you have skills out there like Twisted Personality, Hidden Parasite, Spellproof Armor, stuff like that. It's just not the same level. The Cocoon of Ultra Evolution as well, it's not like they have that on the field all the time and I can just Dust Tornado it and get it off the field before they decide to use its effect. Like, it's always there. It's always live. But I digress. So, Legendary Ocean is my number one. Always will be my number one until it comes out in Speed Duels. But let's move on here. The second one I have is Forgotten Temple of the Deep. This is a continuous trap that says while this card is on the field, this card's name becomes Yumi. So this is a Yumi and a trap card. So let's say we don't get a Legendary Ocean, or we just are playing a different way of playing Water, where we're playing a little bit more conservative. This is a cool way for if your opponent thinks that getting rid of your Yumi on the field is the surefire way to make sure that Levy is not going to go off, you can flip this and this becomes Yumi. So giving Water an extra little wave of power, no pun intended, in a trap card, which should be kind of cool. But this card also says once per turn you can target a level 4 or lower fish, sea serpent, or aqua monster you control, banish that target. During the end phase, special summon the monster banished by this effect. So you can get things off the field for like board wipes or something if your opponent's trying to get rid of something that you crucially need to keep on the field. Let's say you need your Screech to be destroyed by battle, for example, and they're going to destroy it by card effect. You can banish it off the board and then come back in the following turn. Something like that. It's a little bit wonky because then they get to attack you directly, but I didn't say this was going to be perfect. However, I do want to pair this card with another card that I'm about to reveal on this list as well. That way you won't take damage even when your monster leaves the field, and that is Tornado Wall. This card says activate only while Yumi is on the field. While Yumi is face up on the field, you take no battle damage from attacking monsters. Destroy this card if Yumi leaves the field. Obviously this is easier to break than when a 10-year-old Connor was trying to deal with it, All you have to do is pop Yumi and this goes as well. But this is an extra little level of defense that I think could pair nicely with Forgotten Temple, where, you know, you'll banish the monster, but because Forgotten Temple still counts as Yumi, Tornado Wall makes it so that attacking monsters do not do any battle damage. So you are in the clear. And water needs more defense. It strongly needs more defense. It's never had the defense. And the thing is, a lot of the times in water, you want a lot of your deck to be comprised of water cards because of stuff like Fishborg Planter and stuff. So you'd have to run the risk of playing less actual spell and trap cards to make it more relevant. But because this is continuous, it's nice. It can just sit on the field as long as possible. But moving on to another card that deals with Yumi, and that is Amphibious Burgoth MK3. As long as Yumi remains face up on the field, this card can attack your opponent's life points directly. Essentially giving water a toon monster that doesn't have summoning sickness, which sounds fantastic. Give water another way to attack your opponent. Use the water to your advantage. Summon this thing, have it swing from the depths below into your opponent's life points directly. 1500 attack is a lot in 4000 Yu-Gi-Oh, but there are still ways to stop this card. Nightmare Wheel is one of them, and I'm sure we'll have more coming forward into the coming future in this box. But giving this deck another offensive power play that's not related around Levia Dragon would be really, really cool. But with Yumi on the board, this thing becomes 1700, which is really cool if it's a Legendary Ocean, keep in mind. And then 1700 direct does even more. If you pair that with a few other ways to hit your opponent for damage, you've won the game really, really quickly. So I think this card would be really cool in speed duels. My next one is Seven Colored Fish. Now I'm going to pair this with Sea Serpent Warrior of Darkness. The reason I say Seven Colored Fish, though, is that his defense is 800 versus Sea Serpent's, who is 15. The reason I wanted to bring this up is because unless they want to continue having High Tide be the big water monster, normal monster in the game, Seven Colored Fish and Sea Serpent paired with a Legendary Ocean bring these boys up to 2000 attack. And I know what you're thinking, 2000 attack sounds like a lot on a normal summon, but let's talk about how charging Gaia the Fierce Knight already exists in this game, and that's just a free 1900 beat stick. I don't think this would be overpowered. You have to pair it with Yumi, otherwise it's not going to be there. It is 1800, and by itself that's pretty good in speed duels right now, but they've shown in the last set or so that they've gone beyond the 1800 attack with charging Gaia, or at least given other things 1800 attack, like Zoma, for example. So I don't think this is overpowered. Eventually you have to hit cross over that 1800 barrier, get into the 1900 barrier as it is. And yeah, with a Legendary Ocean or Yumi, it goes up to 2000, but I don't think that's overly ridiculous. Be happy I'm not suggesting the other two normal monsters I wanted to bring up in this section. That would be Terra King Salmon and Giga Gaga Gigo. I'm keeping all of these four normal monsters as one. I'm counting these all as one card because I don't think... I think they'd give us Seven Colored Fish first, less defense. If you sphere it, it's easier to get over than it is to get over Sea Serpent. Also, giving them 200 defense as well, Seven Colored would be at 1000, but Sea Serpent would be at 17. That would actually be kind of a problem to deal with. So I see Seven Colored Fish coming first. But the reason I don't think Terra King Salmon or Giga Gaga Gigo would come over here is simply because at 2400 and 2450 attack as 5 stars with the Legendary Ocean, they become 4 stars, and they would be 2600 and 2650 normal summons. That's probably too much of a power creep right now. Maybe in the future we'd get Terra King Salmon, but I don't think they're gonna do that anytime soon for us. I could actually see us getting regular old Gaga Gigo before we get either one of these. So I'm just gonna keep it on Seven Colored Fish and go with that. The next one I wanted to talk about is Eisenbahn. Forgive me if I'm saying that incorrectly. This is a continuous trap that says if a non-water monster is normal or special summoned while you control a water monster, change the summoned monster to defense mode. Another beautiful defensive card we can give water that's continuous, so it's not a one-off. As long as you control a water monster, anything your opponent summons comes out in defense mode. So even if they moth you, as long as you have another water monster, that moth gets summoned in defense and you theoretically don't have to deal with it for one turn, unless of course Gap the Divine Soldier or something comes up board, but you know, that's beside the point. The thing is, this deck needs more defense, it needs more continuous cards, it needs more continuous effects. So if there's a lingering effect, sure, let's give it a lingering defensive effect. It just, you can't be trading one for ones in defense with this deck. It's just not, you don't have the card advantage to do so against other decks. So cool thing with Eisenbahn, allows the opponent to have to play catch up essentially while your monsters are free to summon in attack mode turn one, assuming they're water. But moving on to the next one, let's talk about Divine Dragon Aqua Bizarre. This is a level 5 sea serpent. Half the reason I chose it because of Slushy and the things dealing with sea serpents level 5 or higher. So you can summon it out with Slushy, that'd be great. But also this thing has the effect of once per turn you can tribute one other face-up monster and select one continuous or field spell in your grave and return it to the top of the deck. That's a little slow, but you can get continuous cards from this deck, for example, like Tornado Wall, like Forgotten Temple of the Deep, or you can get field spells like Yumi or Legendary Ocean, throw them back in the top of your deck, and if you have a way to draw them a little bit faster, or at least know what you need to draw for the following turn, it gives you this extra play. But also, it's a sea serpent and it's level 5. So you can summon it back with Slushy, you can also normal summon it for free while Legendary Ocean's out in the field, and this guy would come out at 2300 as a level 4. That's just a really good beat stick to be playing. Obviously, right now we have Kerushin as our level 5 sea serpent of choice based on solely the skill, but if you wanted to play a different skill and have a little bit more firepower at your disposal, Divine Dragon Aqua Bizarre would be the card for you. My next card is Abyss Strom. This might be a little bit strong going in, but like I said, I wanted a top 10 list. Sometimes they're gonna have a little bit of, you know, power creeps in here. Abyss Strom, in my opinion, is really, really strong. If for a side deck card for water, unless the current meta calls for a lot of spell and trap destruction, which kind of right now it does, but in the future it would be more like a side deck card. This normal trap says send a face up Yumi you control to the grave to send all spell and trap cards on the field to the grave. That's really, really dumb. It's really, really good. It doesn't even destroy, it just sends the spell and traps to the grave. But you know, in water, unless you're playing other continuous cards, you can play this card freely, not care about what you're sending to the graveyard. And your opponent's Zomas, Nightmare Wheels, Dust Tornadoes, etc., all gone. All in one fatal swoop. You don't have to, like, drop Levia, hope to God they don't destroy your field spell before you pop their board or their Forgotten Temple. You can just freely do it with this. This card's a little bit quicker in that sense, especially if they like set these traps on their end phase. On their end phase, you can flip this, send the Yumi to the grave, and send their entire back row to the graveyard as well. I think this is really, really good. Again, it's a little bit more defensive. It's a little bit more of a side deck type card for water, but I think water definitely deserves something like this as opposed to playing more like Dust Tornadoes and stuff. Again, they need like less card advantage to do more things. It's kind of like water's thing. Next up, we have a card that goes with Kairushin, and since Kairushin now exists, let's give him the cards he needs. Rage of Kairushin. It's a quick play spell card. It says if Yumi is on the field, and it doesn't even have to be on your side, it's just on the field, target monsters your opponent controls up to the number of water monsters you control, whose original levels are 5 or higher, destroy them, and if you do, the zones they were in cannot be used until the end of the next turn. You can only activate one Rage of Kairushin per turn. So this is a bit of a power creep, but obviously I think water could definitely benefit from this. First off, you have to have Yumi on the board. Second of all, you target monsters your opponent controls up to the number of water monsters you control whose original levels are 5 or higher. In this case, that would only currently be Kairushin, Legendary Fisherman 1 and 2, Fortress Whale, my boy Moby Thick, and Levia Dragon. If we go even further with it, Divine Dragon Aqua Bizarre, like I said, would be another target, but us is really, really powerful in a Legendary Fisherman deck or a Kairushin deck, giving you a defensive play that destroys, or an offensive play because it's a quick play spell card, giving you the ability to board wipe your opponent's monsters, and in addition, they then can't use those zones until the end of the next turn, giving you defense, which is really, really good in water, like I've said. This plus like a Legendary Ocean would bring water up a huge notch, giving the deck more spot removal, as well as a defensive strategy so that they can't use their zones in the future, so they can't like OTK you going forward. And it's got Kairushin in the artwork and the name. Come on, guys, give Kairushin his spell card. And the last card I have on this list is Sea Stealth Attack. This is a continuous trap that says when it's activated, you can activate a Yumi from your hand or graveyard. So that way you don't have to rely like sometimes like on the skill that does that, or try to have it like hard draw it in your hand. While Yumi is on the field, this face-up card gains these effects. Once per turn, you can banish one water monster you control until the end phase. This turn, face-up spell and trap cards you control cannot be destroyed by your opponent's card effects, even if this card leaves the field. So you have a way to protect your Yumi, you have a way to protect any of your continuous cards that you have down, you have a way to protect your spell and trap cards, which this deck has never had before. The second effect is at the start of the damage step, if your water monster, whose original level is 5 or higher, battles an opponent's monster, destroy that monster. Gives the deck more offense. Now, do I expect this Enraged of Kyrishin to be in the same set? Probably not. It's more like a one or the other type thing. But they were both released way back in the Legendary Duelist pack, so I mean, you get where I'm going with this thing. This one acts a little bit differently. The thing with water in general is if you're playing Yumi, you're not really playing any other like spell or traps, and like I said, unless they give it more continuous cards, you're not gonna play a whole lot. So anytime your opponent has something like Dust Tornado or whatever and they didn't side it out against you, it's just getting directed on the field spell every single time. But this can protect that. In addition, it makes it so your Legendary Fisherman, your Kyrishin, or your Levia Dragon, if it battles an opponent's monster, can automatically destroy that opponent's monster immediately before the damage calculation or what have you. So even if they have a Moth on the field and you have something as small as a Legendary Fisherman 1, for example, you could just ram it into that thing, automatically kills it. Same with Kyrishin, same with Levia Dragon. So it does a whole lot for the deck, as a lot of these cards do. But guys, that is my top 10 list for what I think Water could use as support in the Speed Duel box. Let me know in the comments down below if I missed anything that Water could definitely use. I know there are a plethora of options, but these are just some of mine that probably don't get power creeped, that aren't too strong. The last two, like I said, are probably the strongest of them all. They probably wouldn't bring in both of them, but maybe one of them for sure. But a Legendary Ocean, guys, all that does is jumpstart the entire deck. So I would love to see a Legendary Ocean in Water. But let me know what you guys think down below. Comment, like, and subscribe. As always, click that notification bell, as I've said in the past. And, Legendary Ocean, Konami. Alright, I'm out.